around the table?
Did not.
You did too.
I don't remember that.
Why did you run around the table?
For mother to catch us, for mother to clean up the table.
Oh. And I remember when you used to be called skinny connected gas pipes.
Yeah.
Skinny what?
Skinny connected gas pipes. That was the worst thing you could say.
That was when we were around 11, 12 years old.
Yeah. We were very skinny, knobby knees. I still have knobby knees. Yeah.
And I remember when you used to say, I had a pretty schmata on.
Yeah.
And I'd look and say, what a pretty schmata I have on, until I learned out what the schmata meant.
Yeah.
What does it mean?
It means rag.
Rag.
Schmata's a rag.
Do you remember?
She was so angry at us.
Oh, I'm so mad. And you remember, they used to ask you to wink. You used to ask me to wink.
We were teaching you how to wink, I guess. Yeah, I have a vague remembrance of
that. You don't remember being younger?
I don't remember being young. It was too long ago.
I must have been about three, four, or five, and Elma was a few years older.
2 years. Not quite 2 years.
Yeah.
We're practically
in the Lampy apartments. I think we lived in a one-bedroom apartment.
Yes.
And the Malampy Apartments was made by a man, were built by a man named Malampy, and it was for immigrants that came into St. Louis. It was
that I don't know.
Yes, yes. It was for immigrants.
We weren't.
Did your parents come directly from Europe to St. Louis?
Our mother was 13.
Our mother did.
11. How old was my father? My father eventually did too.
They never really met and married in St. Louis.
How old were they when they
you
met?
You remember Grandpa? How they loved you?
Mother was about 18, and Dad was about 28 when they got
you
married.
You were a baby.
What did he do? What was he doing?
He was an egg handler.
Our father came here because he was following some girlfriend, and he followed her here.
Who?
It wasn't, our father was following some girl that he fell in love with.
I didn't know that.
Yeah,
came to America.
Yeah.
I didn't know
even
that.
I knew that, Auntie Elma.
Did he find her?
I don't know.
He found her,
but
she was married.
She was already married.
Yeah.
So
but
what?
He was a spoiled young guy who had no
trade
at all, and he just got into this egg handling, which was to look at eggs.
Yeah.
He was very good at that.
He would hold 3 eggs in one hand and hold it up to the light like this and look, and he could tell the grade, the quality, and put the grade, put it where it belonged.
What did he do
grade.
When there was a fertilized egg?
That was put in a special place, I guess.
Who knows?
Sent it to the restaurant.
So where did he meet your mother?
Well, I guess the Jewish people got together and somehow they met.
I don't really know how they met.
Yeah. I don't know how my mother.
He was a lot older than my mother.
Around
10 years.
Mm-hmm. And my mother was my grandfather was. He painted murals or whatever he on banks. He decorated all over. He would kind of went around my grandfather.
He made designs for linoleum.
But he also worked in banks all over the country, all over Europe.
He went
to America and he landed way down south. He didn't like down the
north.
He went to New York.
Why?
He worked in banks as a muralist, as a painter?
Painter.
Yeah,
I don't know what he painted or how he
I don't know about that, but I know he worked for a company that made linoleum and he worked on the designs.
When he came to America, he was looking for a place that he didn't have to feel threatened.
I know one thing about our grandfather. When he wanted to leave Russia, and he was looking for a place to move to, so while his family was in Russia, he went to Germany, thought maybe they would move to Germany, and he came back and he said it's an anti-Semitic country, he would not live there. That was
smart guy.
before this century.
He was incredible.
And that's why he decided to come with his family
to this country.
He went to America twice.
He was in America twice.
Yes.
The first time he didn't like it.
No, he was in New York. He didn't like New York.
Oh. So then
he went to St. Louis, and he liked St. Louis, and that's where they, then he brought over his wife and
his two daughters.
His two daughters.
They had 2 sons besides.
3 sons.
Was it 3 sons? Mm-hmm. And beautiful. My mother said they were beautiful, fat, bouncing boys. And they died, and the girls survived.
Yeah.
And my mother was.
This was your mother's children you're talking about?
My mother's brothers.
She had 3 brothers.
Okay. All right, yeah.
Siblings,
okay.
Yeah, boys.
And I know why my mother always said you couldn't go out with your pores open. When you take a bath,
yeah.
You have to stay with your pores closed.
Right. Right.
She had
temporary
paralysis, and
there's a medical name for that.
Is that
Bell's palsy?
No.
Bell's palsy.
And she's Dolores. Yeah, Bell's palsy.
Andy had that.
Bell's palsy.
Yeah, Andy had that.
As a child, she had it in Europe.
Yeah, it's a bacterial infection, but it does go away. Yeah, it did go away.
She didn't know that. She
didn't know that. They didn't know that. Nobody knew it then.
Electricity.
Yeah.
To it worked or
at home.
In Russia.
Elma, do you remember when I fell in the toilet and Ida's
which head first?
My sister Ida was taking care of me, and she sits there in that.
She's just a little tiny kid. She's already
tired,
so she sits on the toilet. I saw her trying to balance. So naturally, I laughed.
They treated you rough. I can see that, Lee. Now we know why she's such a.
She lost her balance.
My mother said that when I was, she took me home from the hospital. I was 2 weeks old. I don't know if you guys remember this. And she had put a towel around her head. She washed her hair and put a towel around her head. And she went to pick me up, and I screamed
got
in
scared.
Terror.
Yeah.
And I didn't stop until she gave me to one of you.
That, I don't remember the incident, except
I remember that happened, yes.
If it were for my sisters, they were wonderful, even though she said,
hello. Well, Elma did something like that. She slipped in the bathtub and fell and hurt herself.
Yeah. I laughed.
Yeah, I laughed.
She's got a wonderful sense of humor.
But it's not me.
But I know you kids fought. A lot.
We did a lot. We would fight, but there was never any animosity.
What's the age difference between Ida and Elma?
2 years.
2 years.
Minus.
22 months.
22 months, all right. Mm-hmm. What's the difference between Lee and Ida?
45
Nine
years.
Years.
Pardon?
9 years.
9 years,
but
okay.
They were really wonderful sisters.
Seven
if
years.
It weren't for them, I don't know what would have happened.
You would have survived.
Listen, my earliest memory is my mother saying,
I didn't want you. I tried to get rid of you. She did.
She did. I took hot baths and I drank mustard and I jumped off the chairs and you still came.
Tough.
Yeah.
No, that's a hard thing to live with.
Oh, I didn't think so. I thought it was pretty special.
Well, it might also have shown her that she was one tough kid, and boy, she can do it.
And I remember I'd say, Mama, do you love me? She said, yeah, I love you like poison. I don't think that's
camera shaking.
Tragic, but.
that was my mother.
At 60-some, it's all right, right?
Heard you and some guy started kissing, and I was real unhappy. Do you remember? You said,
I don't remember that.
And I said, Elma doesn't love me. And you said, talk to Elma, she loves you still. Anyway,
Aaron brings up things that I don't remember when he was a child.
Yeah, Lane, too. She has a
they were such
a whole different experience I don't even know about.
They were such great sisters. They really were. And you don't ever.
You didn't bother us. We didn't bother you.
I tried to bother you. You didn't even know you were bothered. You had some jewelry or something, and you were going on a date, and I didn't want you to go, and I hid it, and you didn't even know about it. It didn't stop you. You don't remember any of these things?
Now I know where my jewelry is, but I can't find it. Lee's hiding it.
No, this was when I was a kid.
Yeah. I remember you being around. I remember when we lived in Malampe, and her dad had that grocery store. You were a little
She was never in Malampe.
She was not on Hodermond. I was 12.
I must have been awful young.
But we had the grocery store in the black neighborhood.
Yeah, that's on Gamble Street.
Gamble Street.
Remember my funny little dog called Pet?
Yes.
My first girlfriend was a little black
little
girl.
Black girl. Yeah.
And I loved her. Josie May.
Yeah,
you fixed her.
Yeah, I think there's a picture of you with
and
her.
And I went to Josie May's house
with the dog
playing.
She had pigtails.
Yeah, no. And we were playing, and Josie May and I were kind of fighting over something, and Josie's mother said, Josie May, you bring me a switch. No, this is true, and Josie May brought her a stick, and I was horrified because she started to hit this little, my friend, and she says, this will teach you never argue with a little white girl, and it just stuck in my head. I felt so bad and so guilty, because kids just fight, you know, and it was nothing. And that taught me a lesson about prejudice. I'll never forget.
Now, did it change the relationship at all? Did you go on being?
I don't remember that. Yeah. All I know is I love Josie Mange. I think she loved
me. It seems to me you sort of had to separate and couldn't play with each other. I have feeling.
Because I do remember one of the first, my mother hardly ever hit us, but one of the first beatings I got is because I didn't tell her where I'd been, and she didn't know where I was, and she said, "You tell me when you go somewhere." She was terrified because we lived in Gamble Street.
Yeah.
And then she told me it was all black
neighborhood.
Except there was a Jewish family upstairs.
Yeah.
Nice fat family.
They were
fat,
terrible.
Kids.
Yeah.
They were all right.
They weren't nice.
No, I didn't say they were nice.
They just had nice fat family.
And that was the time that my mother.
They owned the house we lived in.
And they got rich too, because he was
a junk man.
He started to get rich. But I remember I was upstairs playing.
Who was that?
The family that lived upstairs, we had a store on the corner.
A white Jewish family.
And the mothers like that, and the little, were there two little girls or something? I'm not sure, but they all had.
Didn't they have a lot of kids?
I think she had a lot of kids.
She had more than two.
And I was running around upstairs, and I wouldn't come down, and I fell and cut my chin open. And mother started hitting me, and my daddy grabbed me.
Hit yourself.
She said, yeah, that was right. She was so scared because it was just, I was bleeding, my daddy.
I'm surprised she did that.
I also remember my mother said that I was my dad's favorite because I wasn't afraid of him. He'd bite me and I'd bite him back.
I'll tell you something. If more than one person talks at a time, it would be unintelligible.
Put her in Laurel's arms and she just sat
there.
I remember this. You're bringing back ideas. I forgot
that.
And the whole thing was just, I wish I
had. We really were special that
day. I remember.
Yeah. Well, you were talking about
Malafi apartments.
Yeah.
You know, this man, the reason he did that for the immigrants is because he was an immigrant. He came over this country. I guess he was an Irishman, and he had a hard time. So he made money somehow, and he built these apartments for people who came from Europe, you know, immigrants. And there was a group of Jewish people that lived there.
I don't remember families. I remember children being there. And as I was telling you,
you remember this
one hunchback girl. She was older than we were. I don't know how old she was. We were sort of afraid of her. Had a terrible hump on her back.
She was pretty face. She had a pretty face. Yeah.
She sort of dominated us. And it was a great big yard. As I said, it was a U-shaped apartments, buildings and apartments. And a great big yard, concrete, all concrete, where we played. Mm-hmm. It was a one-bedroom apartment. And I remember we had a big overstuffed chair that I like to sit in.
Well, the chair I don't remember. I remember the hallway. They put a swing up there.
Oh my God.
In the doorway. And I think Elma was swinging and I got hit. And then they took the swing down. Yeah, I have a scar there someplace from that.
I fell out of it.
But there was also a Jewish family living upstairs, the Silvermans. You remember them?
I fell out of the swing and hit that thing up there.
Yes, Rose and Philip and Ben. Was his name Ben? Yeah. One brother was Ben. Yeah, that's real.
I don't remember their living.
This was all before.
Yeah, we used to play with them.
We knew them because one of the parents was a landsman of our father's. Our father knew them
because
they came from the same town.
With us.
That I don't remember. And when we were older, our father had a store.
Where were you when Dad was shot? Where were you when Dad was shot?
He was shot?
I in Detroit?
Were you there by that time?
I might have been in Detroit.
Yeah, because I was home when he got shot.
Because Mom was shot, was away. She was at a department store shopping. Dad had just let his insurance lapse because he didn't want to pay any more insurance because all that money was for nothing.
Oh my God.
He had a gun to take care of everything in case anything happened. Ida was babysitting me, and she was making scrambled eggs, and we were giggling and thinking it was very hysterical. And Dad comes in covered with blood, and I hear him say, "Ida, I'm shot."
Yeah.
And then all I remember then was Mom coming home and an ambulance. But you probably remember more about it than I do.
He was held up, and he reached for the gun that he had, and he was shot right in the temple. It was
just like today.
Yeah, it came through, it came in.
It wasn't invented in the last couple of years.
No. Do you remember anything more about that?
No.
I remember he had a dent in his forehead from that.
Yeah, he had a dent in his, and I remember that.
Dent in his forehead.
Yeah, and I remember mother coming home and saying, "Now we're not covered, there's no insurance. You let the insurance lapse, you wouldn't pay for it."
He was in the hospital.
Yeah.
And he never had a memory of what happened.
Didn't?
No.
Boy, I remember it.
Well, I mean, and he didn't remember the incident because of the shot. It affected. I don't know whether it was a trauma or it actually affected.
Do you remember how did you get the ambulance or what did you? Well, you don't remember what happened for you?
No. It's all very vague.
And was he robbed this time?
Oh, yeah. I guess he was. I don't know if he was actually robbed or the person just ran away after they shot him. I don't know.
And it was right out on the street?
In the store.
We had a grocery store.
And I do remember about our father that I was terrified. This reminds me of another. I was a tomboy. Remember?
I was a tomboy.
Everybody was. And my mother used to say that we were both of us scaredy cats, but Ida was
the brave one.
The brave one. There was this bully that was in the street neighborhood or something, and you beat him up. And you never told anybody. You'd go in and you'd put Mercurochrome on and take care of everything. And
One time I had a fight with a boy and I was sitting on him.
She sat on me too.
Because that's what the kids did. So I sat on
him.
And everybody laughed.
That's his name, Al.
So I got up and said, "Something's wrong."
Didn't work.
He started to laugh. Is that
the boy started to laugh. And I knocked him down sitting on the guy. Because that's what the boys did with each other. So he was starting to laugh. I thought, "What? There's something wrong here." I got up.
But I used to be scared to death of animals.
I must have been about 8 or 9 years old then.
But I was afraid of animals. And I remember if I saw a dog, I was going to run across the street. My dad brought this little tiny dog home. And this little dog looked at me, and I looked at it, and it ran under the table, scared of me. And I thought, well, gee whiz, if it's scared of me. And so, and I felt, remember Pat?
Yes.
He was the most ugly looking. He was my darling dog, and my mother.
That was the only dog we ever kept for any length of time.
Yeah, he was my
dog. The only dog we had that I
thought that was pretty smart.
Well, they would try to bring a dog home, and it never worked. It got sick, the dog catchers caught it.
Well, that's what happened to Pat. We all were sick with fever or something, and my mother told me but I do remember you guys fighting over whose turn it was to do something.
I was always cleaning up the dishes, cleaning up the table and washing the dishes. We had to take turns. We always fought whose turn it was. Washing the dishes was worse than cleaning up the table.
I remember that, and running around the table.
That I don't remember. Probably there were a lot of episodes like that.
And I used to tickle at his feet until she stomped on my hands and sat on my sandals.
Did you go to school together at all? Were you ever in the same school at the same time?
And we walked to school all the time. We walked home for lunch and we walked back to school.
I'll never forget, there was an incident. It was raining, and we had blue rain.
We got new blue raincoats, navy blue raincoats.
With
the hood.
Yeah.
You've heard that story.
Yeah, we were.
And walking home, all of a sudden, I pointed at Ida, or she pointed at me.
No.
Blue was running down.
That's not the worst thing. We had ice cream cones. My ice cream cone was fine, but she said, "Is your ice cream cone good?" And I looked at it, the blue fell. And then I had a little bite of one. I was so mad that she asked me about it.
She's getting the picture. We were all right coming home and running down all over us.
It's a gray raincoat.
We have to wear those raincoats again.
I just remember
throw out perfectly
the ice cream.
We were robbed, too. I remember we were robbed because I was sort of in a crib and I saw somebody was coming in the window.
Someone broke in. I don't know if we were robbed. I and I slept in the front room. That was on the Nathaniel.
Yeah, because I remember.
This wasn't in the real bad 1980s where there's all this crime, right?
This was terrible.
One person at a time.
Somebody was coming in the window and I woke her up. And I started shaking Elma, she wouldn't wake up. But they must have frightened the guy, so he ran out. He didn't come into the house.
And I guess that must have
scared him. But there were, it was shown that there were marks that he got in or there. It was obvious when the police came the next day that there somebody had tried to get in.
And I remember when I was a little kid, I used to go in the store and draw pictures of naked women because my sisters used to go to art class or something, and I'd draw naked pictures of naked women on box tops and stuff, and the colored people would come in and they'd say, "Oh, look at these naked women. She's gonna be an artist, ha ha." You don't remember that?
I went to art school in the
When you were that young?
Well, no, I was a teenager then.
Well, I was five. I was about five when I started drawing all these little things.
So she'd be 14.
Yeah. No, I was older than that, but I went to with Mrs. Werby. Do you remember?
Sure, you were older than that.
Yeah, I was older. In fact, I went to that art class until I got married. When I became engaged, they had a party for me.
Did I go to the party?
No, it was just for the class.
And I remember having a girlfriend come into our house. This must have been already in Detroit, and we'd already moved out of
there. Yeah, this was at the party.
And I looked at these pictures on the wall, and they were absolutely shocked.
Sounds all right, though, with the other voices.
Well, it's going to be mixed up.
What's so wonderful about it? So unusual. I thought, oh, my God. See what you did to me?
Just a minute, Melvin. Are we supposed to be meeting everybody?